What's up, world? It's your boy Drew Marcy here for How to Rap, and in this video we're gonna tell you what we believe is the biggest lie told to anybody who's ever wanted to be a rapper. Look, I've been coaching rappers from around the world for over half a decade now, in addition to 15 plus years experience as a rapper myself, and so many rappers get discouraged by this and even give up on rap, losing motivation because of this lie that we're about to debunk right here, right now. Now, if you don't like being lied to about your rap career and want the God's honest truth every time, be sure to subscribe to this channel with notifications, because we drop weekly videos based on real life experience as a professional rap artist. And be sure to pick up our free full-length book, Self-Made Classic, How to Drop a Great Project on a Tight Budget, so that you know how to release your next album, mixtape, EP, or single, even if you don't have a lot of outside money to spend. You can pick up that free book by visiting the first link in the video description box below. Now, I'm sure that the suspense is killing you, so we're gonna tell you right now what this big lie that has ruined so many rap careers is, and then we're gonna give you example after example after example of famous influential rappers debunking this notion in this lie that we're about to say. Now, the biggest lie you've ever been told about becoming a rapper is that you have to be born with it in order to succeed. Now, what does born with it really mean? Now, this phrase rears its ugly head in several different ways. First lie and version of this born with it thinking is that if you start rapping and you aren't immediately good, or you're not good basically overnight, that means you'll never be good. While nobody believes this notion in any other skill in life that you actually get good at, right? So people don't really think Michael Jordan was dunking and doing fadeaways when he was 12 years old. And in fact, in middle or high school, he famously got cut off of his team. But for some reason, when it comes to rap, people seem to think that people like Eminem were always good at this thing. And when I say people, I don't mean Eminem himself. He doesn't even believe that. Recently on Mike Tyson's Hot Boxing podcast, Slim Shady himself talked about how hard it was and how bad he was in the beginning of his rap career.
LL Cool J was the one who made me like first start writing rhymes. And I was like 12, 13 maybe. And it sucked. You know, I wasn't good, but like I had to keep practicing and practicing and practicing. I gave it up for a little while, then I started again back when I was like 15 and started being able to kind of put songs together. And then I just was like, I was never really good at much else.
So here we see Marshall Mathers himself, Eminem Slim Shady, saying not only did he suck when he started, but that he had to practice and practice and practice and even gave up for a little while before he actually got good. Which brings up a second lie that's inherent in this born with it thinking, the idea that you don't need to practice, it should just come naturally. And inherent in what Eminem was saying was that he had to practice and practice and practice. It didn't just come naturally to him. Now, this is a concern we see on a channel like this all the time. You see some struggle rapper, somebody didn't even know what they're talking about, in the comments saying things like, why should you watch videos like this? Rap should just come naturally. It just comes to you. This is a falsehood that's often perpetuated by people that either have never gotten good at anything in their life, so they're not aware of the concept of practice and improvement, or they just kind of gave up in rap and they're trying to project their negativity onto you as a rapper. Eminem, on the other hand, one of the greatest rappers of all time, doesn't believe that. He is very clear that he needed to practice and improve and accept that he would suck at the beginning in order to become a master at this art. Now, the third key component of the born with it thinking, and the most common one on this channel, is this lie that you can't be taught how to rap. Now again, major influential rap artists don't agree with this themselves. In a video, funny enough, titled Mace Taught Me How to Rap, Jim Jones of Dipset explains in no uncertain terms that legendary rapper Mace taught him how to rap.
Mace actually showed me, he was the first person to show me how to rap. That's how I learned how to rap. When Mace showed me how to do it, it was kind of like a format, and it took a pen and a pad, and it was kind of dope. It was like calculated the way he showed me how to do it.
Funny enough, in that same interview, he keeps sort of rambling about this point and directly dispels the notion that rap should just come naturally, because it didn't for him.
It was like calculated the way he showed me how to do it. So it was like, you know, it's like with anything, like some people are talented artists, and some people could work hard at being good at that craft. Mm-hmm. And that was what rap was for me. It wasn't it wasn't natural for me.
And even more interestingly, to tie it all together with what we've already talked about in this video, Jim Jones brings up Eminem in the very next sentence when talking about rap development.
In Harlem, the way that from Harlem rap was kind of different from everybody else because our compounds were so precise. This is how, this is like what people hear Eminem do. But Eminem kind of took our shit and went all the way to the extreme. That's why you always hear him talk about Big L and all these rappers, because the compound and element of our music was kind of special.
Now, in this case, when he says compound rhyming, Jim Jones is talking about something that we more commonly call multi-syllable rhyming, which is a style that both Harlem rappers, as he mentioned, and Eminem uses. And if you'd like to learn more about how to do multi-syllable or compound rhyming yourself, I have a video called How to Write a Rap: Beginner to Eminem Rhyme Schemes in 11 Minutes, which you can view by visiting the video description box below or the info card in the corner. In any case, you can see that both Eminem, Jim Jones are dispelling all of the notions that anybody, famous rappers who actually have influence on the culture, are just born with it, or that they don't have to practice it, or that they're not taught certain aspects of it. These guys are showing you that it's just not true. Now, I want to end this video with a little bit of an action plan if you're interested in learning how to rap and you're watching this as a relative beginner. Now, knowing that you don't have to be born with it or come out of the womb spitting like J. Cole from the minute you take your first breath, you know that there's a way that you can step by step get good at this thing. The first thing I would suggest is starting small, right? And just starting with basic writing of raps and then getting more and more advanced as you go, sort of like the gym where you start with lighter weight and then add on as you get stronger. We have a video called How to Start Rapping in 10 Easy Steps, which has almost 500,000 views, which will walk you step by step through the initial process. And you can see that in the video description box below. And we have an Instagram page at How to Rap Nation that specifically gives rap tips multiple times a day, which you can follow by visiting the video description box or just checking it out on Instagram yourself. Main idea here is, just like anything in life, if you practice, you work hard, you trust that you can improve, and that you take expert advice from people who've already been there, you can get better, and yes, you can really do this. You can learn how to rap. Now, I want to see you in the comments. What is the most discouraging thing anybody has ever told you about learning how to rap? We talked about a couple lies in this video, and we dispelled them, but I want to hear more from you directly about what's discouraging you or how people have held you down so that we can continue to make content and speaking directly to your issues. So I'll see you in the comments with some of those stories. Be sure to pick up that free book. Be sure to check out all those videos. I've been your host, Drew Marcy. I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you on the next one.